Welcome back, everyone. Dr. Laura Waters joins us this morning. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. Good.
We're talking about the holidays, all right? We got Thanksgiving done, and now it's December, and everyone's in that holiday spirit.
Yep.
But it's important to stay stress-free during that, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
What are some tips that we have for maybe people with kids that need to make sure that we're all staying well-adjusted and not losing our cool?
Yeah. The first thing that you want to do when you have kids is you want to make sure that you keep your routines as consistent as you can.
Right.
A lot of times, holiday plans and things throw off kids' routines, which can create a lot of misbehaving when they're exhausted, when they're tired, when they're stressed. And
yeah.
So the more routines that you can create around keeping mealtime the same, bedtime's the same, that sort of thing, will help decrease and minimize some of those behaviors that are unwanted.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking, is maybe don't budge too much on that
yeah.
bedtime or too much on the sweets given and things like that, right? It's tough this time of year, though.
It is.
Yeah.
It is.
What else is there that's important to do, though, from a parent's perspective?
I think one of the biggest things is that parents a lot of times focus on making sure, you know, that their kids are getting these amazing gifts
yeah.
and that they're, you know, getting the latest, greatest toys and that sort of thing. But really what you remember the most oftentimes is the time that you spend with your family. And I think that's what we need to focus on, is spending that time making those memories, because as a kid, you remember more about what you did with your parents, you know, making
yeah.
those cookies or what you did with your grandparents and that sort of thing. You don't remember the gift that you got. And I also think that creating a sentiment around, you know, giving is better than receiving, and having your kids mm-hmm. focus on that. If you have time to go do something where you can go volunteer at a toy drive or at a food pantry or something like that, I think
right.
is also a good idea.
Salvation Army, always good to do that,
absolutely.
Right? They're big with that. And, you know, going back to the memories, yeah, when I remember certain things about gifts, I also remember my parents getting frustrated because they couldn't assemble them. That's the stuff I remember, not specifically what we have, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So always important to be able to do that, and you know, just keep those routines the same. Yeah, I totally agree. And you also mentioned in your email to us about, you know, don't feel the need to have to give to everyone all the time
yeah.
as far as your friends and things go. We had someone talk about it's okay to just accept and
yeah.
relax, say thank you.
I think, you know, one of the things that I've always heard is that love is spelled T-I-M-E, and I think mm-hmm. that, you know, giving the gift of your time is also just as good and even better sometimes than
right.
giving actual tangible things.
Exactly. Very important to note. So these are things we got to take with us for the next month, well into January, right?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much. Dr. Laura Waters joining us this morning. Appreciate the tips and hope you have a good holiday as well.
Thank you. You too.
All right. Stay with us. Daybreak in 10 is up next in a few minutes.